Bismillah walhamdulillah wa salatu salam ala rasulillah wa ba'd. Regarding the issue of praying salatul jama'ah, the congregational prayer in the masajid with gaps between the people in the rows, with the gaps between the worshippers. The scholars have stated that despite this not being the norm, despite this not being the standard, extraordinary situations call for special measures. And we see this precedent set in the Quran as well. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَلَيْسَ عَلَيْكُمْ جُنَاحٌ أَن تَقْصُرُوا مِنَ الصَّلَاةِ إِنْ خِفْتُمْ أَن يَفْتِنَكُمُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. There is no fault upon you in shortening the prayer, especially when you fear attack. When you fear that there may be danger, then shorten the prayer. And the next verse in Surah An-Nisa goes on to explain how we pray Salatul Khawf, the prayer of fear, with one group praying with the Imam and another group behind them standing guard. And then in the midst of the prayer, they switch places. Then they switch places again. All of that is not the norm, but due to the special circumstance. So with the current situation, considering people's health, people's well-being, and with proper medical advice, then praying with gaps becomes an issue of necessity to avoid the greater harm of people becoming sick. And the fiqh ruling itself of closing the gaps in the rows, the ruling of closing the gaps in the rows, this is not of the arkan of the salah, it's not of the pillars of the prayer. According to the vast majority of the scholars, this is of the sunan. It's of the sunan of the prayer. It's not of the arkan, the pillars, or the wajibat, the obligations, or the shurut, the conditions of the prayer, but rather it's of the sunan of the salah, meaning that not doing it, even in a normal circumstance, would not invalidate the prayer, according to the majority of scholars. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, فَإِنَّ تَسْوِيَةَ الصَّفْ مِنْ تَمَامِ الصَّلَاةِ. He said that straightening the rows is from the perfection of the prayer. Yet not doing so doesn't invalidate the prayer. So this is the consideration that has been taken by the scholars. And we see prayers being prayed with distancing between the worshippers all over the Muslim world, in Mecca, Medina, Jerusalem, and other than that, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best.